Well, hello. Today is Friday, December 27th, 2019, and this is Angela Hooper-Menifield with your HR moment from Menifield and Associates. So this is the last Friday of 2019. It's been a great year, busy year, and one of the things I've really had the honor and privilege of doing this past year is trying to add value to people who supervise and manage people. Supervising people is not easy work, right? And oftentimes, this is the time of year where things can become a little stressful for supervisors. I'm a part of a couple of Facebook groups that are dedicated to supervisors. And so every now and again, I go in there and peruse the types of questions that people are asking. And so one of them that I've noticed that's been pretty regular this time of year is, how do you handle leave time, right? This time of year, because if you run a business that requires that people work, if you're in sales, retail, banks, you know, other than the holiday, they're open. Let's say you airport workers. I mean, they work year round. So there are many businesses that require us to still work during the holidays, right? I mean, there are some businesses that can take off a week or two during this time of year and they allow everybody to take vacation time. But many of our businesses don't have that luxury. And so as a supervisor, we are often called upon to make the what would be considered equitable and judicial decisions as to who gets to take off and when, especially if everybody wants off the same day. So how do you handle that? And that's a really good question because, you know, there's a couple of implications if it's not handled right. One, people decide to take off anyway, right? So in other words, they didn't get approved leave, but they don't show up for work. Well, that's not good because then that puts a burden on the people who are there and then they have more work to do, and or you as the supervisor sometimes have to come in and cover. So handling this right on the front end is the first step. So one of the things that I would recommend that we do on the front end is have the discussion with everybody well before the holiday, right? Because this is the time of year that we have a few, you know, there's Thanksgiving and usually people don't want to come back to work that Friday. And then there's also the Christmas and New Year's. Different people have different beliefs and traditions. Some people celebrate certain holidays a little bit more than others and some don't celebrate any. So that's a topic for another discussion to ensure we're fair and balanced in honoring those who choose not to partake and that we don't have mandatory events that we make people go to. But if we have these discussions with the team ahead of time, we can be proactive. So a couple of things we can do is first, let's just lay out what are the days that people want off and then explain what is the bare minimum that we need for coverage. So one of the things that I used to do is, you know, of course, typically in every operation, there's a person who has a core task, but then who else can do that? You know, there's coverage, right? Because people have vacation time and they should be allowed to take off. So who can cover? And then my role was to ensure that we had adequate coverage. We don't have to have maximum coverage because again, many of our customers are off too. But as an office that has phones that ring, visitors that show up and work, you know, payroll that has to be run, and whatever the case may be, everybody can't take off. Now, for me, oftentimes I would say, I'll be here. So I can cover certain things like answering the phones and doing things like that. And as the leader, office head, or whatever, that's no big deal for me. So one, I'm creating a culture that says when I don't have to be off or because I live nearby or maybe my family is local, whatever, I don't have to take off so I can work. So I allow those who maybe don't have family local and this is a difficult time of year for them to ensure they can get an extra day or so. So that's something I can do as an individual. And when people see you sacrificing for the overall team, some of them will do that too. But again, we lay out the parameters. What's the necessary coverage and where are the days that there are multiple requests? Now, sometimes what we can do is see if they can work it out between themselves. And more times than not, this has been the case where I would share that, you know, for Friday after Thanksgiving, we have three people that want to be off and at least one of you needs to come to work. Sometimes people are just asking off because they have leave they need to burn. And so they could say, oh, okay, well, fine. I don't have to have Friday, but can I get that Monday or can I get Wednesday? people tend to negotiate. Now, there are a few occasions where it just doesn't work. Nobody wants to compromise, and the supervisor has to then make a judicial decision. But tell people what the criteria is. Is it length of service? Is it based on performance? Is it, you know, like I said, seniority? But what is it based on? But then also explain that we're going to have a rotation. So if Angela is able to take off Christmas Eve or the day after Christmas in 2019, guess what happens in 2020? You know, let's say my coworker is Michelle. Michelle gets first priority. And so then it becomes clear, but again, we're making all of these decisions like in September, because also one of the things that as a good supervisor I would try to do is say, hey, you know, guys, let's put in leave requests now for the holiday season and do so 2 or 3 months ahead of time, because people want to buy plane tickets, they want to make hotel reservations, vacation plans, let their family know, adjust with their spouses, kids school pickup, and all these other things they have to adjust. So saying yay or nay on December 15th is another reason why people get upset. And then they get upset, and again, what do? They call in sick. And it's hard for us to say they're not sick, right? Maybe they're sick because they overindulged on Christmas, but it's not a good look. So the other thing that has to be expressed is, absent some type of medical documentation or some other documentation supporting an unexpected absence, during this busy time of year when people, and I mean busy with leave requests, you need to know ahead of time that I may not approve any call-ins the day of. Because again, we have an expectation that everybody show up. So, is it challenging? Can it be stressful? Yes, but you get to dictate how stressful it is, because you can be proactive and not reactive in how you respond. You know, I was off this week, right? Now, there was nobody I had to ask for permission with, but there were clients and other things I had to juggle. And if some of them wanted to do some things during the course of time that I had not scheduled to work, guess what? Angela would have been working, because the life goes on, business goes on, the world does not stop because there's a holiday. And again, everybody doesn't even celebrate and recognize the same holidays. We're so caught up in what we do as a country and a society that we forget that everybody doesn't even meet off the same time. You know, these are some of the things I've even had to learn being in a BNI group, because many of my BNI members are Jewish. And we are taking off for holidays that I've never taken off for in the past. But I respect and honor that, right? And so I say that to say, be cognizant of what people want and need, but be proactive. So have the conversation. Again, allow the team to work it out. You would be amazed at who is willing to sacrifice for someone else, given the opportunity, or had they known. Because again, sometimes people are only taking off because that's the expectation, or they have leave to burn. And so have the conversation, make sure everybody knows what is the minimum coverage we need and what's the expectation and how we should handle it if an unforeseen emergency does occur. But never only schedule one person to work in a critical area around the holiday season, because if they do have an emergency and something happens, then the whole operation can be compromised. So again, the smaller the business, it's definitely more of a challenge, but it's a challenge that can be overcome. So when it comes to holiday leave, you want to be equitable, you want to be fair, but you want to be proactive in saying yay and nay and having the team work together as a unit to determine what do we need to do to, again, best serve our clients. Because that's what the end goal is, right? We're in business to provide a service, whatever that service may be. So how do we do that most effectively and efficiently? So I hope this has been helpful for some of you, because again, next week people will want to be off again, right? Maybe not as much, but consider who took off this week when you're making decisions off based on who can take off next week. Because again, you can't, for most businesses, shut the whole thing down. So again, this is Angela Hooper-Menifield with your HR Moment. Today is Friday, December 27th. 2019, the last Friday of the year. So thank you guys for your support. Some great and exciting things are coming in 2020. I can't wait to share them with you. And again, keep inboxing me, asking those questions, and continuing to grow yourself as a supervisor in your organization. Take care. Bye.